Good morning, children. I hope all you are fine. Today I am going to start video for grade 10, history, chapter 5, social and religious reform movements. In this chapter, we are covering some points, which is the introduction. What is the social and religious reform movement? And why it started? And how it started? Who and who are those persons who start all this work? Now, the social reform. Who are the famous social reformers, and those reformers start some movements in some samaj. First we have Brahmo Samaj, then the Young Bengal Movement, then Arya Samaj, and then the Prachi Samaj. So we will start with this introduction. Okay, what is the social reformers? It means, you know that a social reformer is an attempt to reform a society that practices discrimination among its members. We know that because in a society when we are living, there are so many discrimination happen. It means according to gender, caste, races, according to color, according to money, all these things are discrimination. So those discrimination is not good for society. So for remove those who are discrimination, the social reformers came in front and they try to start some organization which they call Samaj. So now it is the basic aim of those reformation to provide to everyone's value of a self-respect. I mean, if we are talking about for each and every single person, it doesn't matter at which caste, which gender that person was belong, that person's self-respect is important. And if he or she is treated very badly and exploited, it means their self-respect is gone down. So there is no need to write to destroy anyone's self-respect and dignity. We are living in one country. There is a secular country. So it means there is not this kind of discrimination done. So in the 19th century, it means from starting of the 1801, it is considered that the reform movements is also compulsory and also required for those time of condition. It means because on that time, Europeans came. The Europeans already started some business trade and the many more problems and try to capture the India's political matters, economic matter, everything. So and they all knows that in everywhere, democracy, nationalism and equality started finding their roots in India when the Europeans in their India. So from that time when they start, where is the roots of this, they start to linking to each and one single person. But if between all of the person only discrimination is there, how they can just manage and try to combine all the people to form one national movement? So they put forth the theory of a white man's burden. For the Europeans, they put the forth of a theory that white man's burden, and thus all burden are not properly, because those are the white men. They thought that they all are a civilized people, and all the other peoples who are that time living in India, they all are uncivilized people. So this is also a thing which is try to destroy the Indian self-respect and dignity. And many start understanding the Indian tradition in new perspective. From the past time, from the Vedic time only, we know that Indian culture, Indian traditions, Indian values is a very precious, it is a very important. But you know what we are missing every time? We are not thinking according to our ways, we are thinking according to other ways. So when some problems when we are facing, that time we have to just go back and check, okay, what are the values? In the present time also, whole world is known that what is the India's value, culture, tradition, everything. But if the time is coming that we only miss those facts. We only just remove this fact. So that time, those samaj, those movements came because they tried to remind again that what is India's value. And that time, Indians, especially the youngsters, they start to thinking about a new way on those values, those traditions, those cultures, and they try to understand, okay, whatever the thing is there in our hand, it is our precious thing. If any European or any matter who's coming, they can take wealth from the country, but they can't take our culture from our country. They can't take our tradition from us. They can't take our values from us. They can take only money, but they can't take all these things. So this is the thing the people, the reformers try to explain those, the normal public. And that's why they started the reformation movement. In the sum, and those is also like some communities which is the according to Vedic culture, Shudras are there. Those are every time exploited by the other three categories, which is the Brahman, Kshatriya and Vaishyas. So for those also is a try to equality type of thinking the people start to giving. Now is a like a Middle Ages and ancient time, the movement is started during the British period were a different. And in British period, there are some more discrimination is there and some more social problems there, like a child marriage, like a widows, like a sati system, this type of like a gender discrimination, restriction, widows remarriage, denial of education to Shudras, other lower level categories. So those also are the problems, not only about the people's cultural tradition, about the more thing which is spread in all social areas. And those important for the social development, because if they are not coming out for this problem, the country will never develop. So some reformers came in a front. According to those reformers, maybe Raja Ram Mohan Rai, Dayanand Saraswati, Rana Jyotiba Phule, Swami Vivekanand, Annie Besant, Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan, Periyar, Narayan Guru, those all became part of those movements. So those all famous reformers, famous social reformers known in the history. Now first we talk about Brahma Samman. It is started in 1772 to 1833. The Brahma Samman started by the Raja Ram Mohan Rai. He started by the Raja Ram Mohan Roy, which was the year of the born and that was 1832. Okay, he started the Brahma Samaj, and he was the chief initiator of the social reformer movement in India. He had a deep knowledge in a Sanskrit, Persian and Arabic language. Those people, it's not like they don't know anything. They knows very well all the different languages also. And those knows the very well for the how they have to try to encourage people. Now, he was well versed in the Hindu philosophical critic and the Quran also. And he had learned Hebrew and the Greek to read Bible also. He learned some other languages like Hebrew and Greek to learn Bible, because he was really wanted to all deep knowledge from the, all the ritual books, all the holy books. Now he started Atmiya Sabha in Kolkata with some friends, and after that Shosho in religious melodies from Sarai Bengal, and he started Brahma Samaj in 1828. This Samaj started in 1828 with some friend, and starting with some friends. After that, he follow wanted to rebuild a new Hindu society as a new philosophical foundation of the Upanishad. And then the Governor General William Bentinck brought in the law prohibiting sati system in 1829. Raja Ram Mohan Rai tried to develop rationally among the common people through journalism. He published a journal named Samved Kumudi in Bengal language. Now some important aspect of the Brahmo Samaj were advocate monotheism. Next, opposed meaningless rituals, because he is talking about social reformers according to religious thing. So he tried to introduce to the public that opposed all the meaningless rituals. There is no use for those type of rituals. Then every person should live with a dignity and with no law or ritual should violate their provision. Then Brahma Samaj intended to assure equality to women by opposing polygamy. It advocated to share a property to honor dignity of life to widow. It also opposed child marriage. Child marriage, remarriage for the widows and the sati system, those on that time especially exploited the girl child or the women. Because child marriage means when the girl married her children in a lower age, in the small age, she really don't know how to handle. Second, widow. And there is no system for to remarriage for the widow. It means she was treated like she did some very bad crime and she just opposed from the all the facilities also. And sati system, it means in the some communities or some societies, if a husband died, then with the husband's dead body, the female, the wife is also, they have to bury it. So this type of social rituals, they have to finish it. The Brahma Samaj declared that one can take good things from anywhere. It also declared that Upanishad and Vedas also advocate these principles. He was open to receive good thoughts on from the West and he gave importance to English education. Because in English education, he knew that for the development of the any particular person or the according to world, if they want to go, it means English education or the modern education is important and this is the link to go forward in the with the world. Now, Raja Ram Mohan Roy wanted to the Indians to welcome the thinking process of the European. You know, Europeans' thinking process was different than the Indians. Reason? Because they know very well that what is the actual thing in the present time is going on. It is not a whatever the society's values. It is according to society's value, but just to try to modify on those things. Rabindranath Tagore was called Raja Ram Mohan Roy as the hubbian of the modern Indian, progenitor of the Indian social reformers, and the prophet of the Indian nationalism. So here Raja Ram Mohan Roy, the Brahmo Samaj, you can end. Now the next is a Young Bengal Movement. The Young Bengal Movement is also started by Henry Louis Vivian D'Arezzo by 1820 to 1830s. It is started by Henry. Louis D'Arezzo. So Young Bengal Movement started by the Henry Louis Vivian D'Arezzo. He was an Anglo-Indian person. It means his father was a Portuguese and his mother was Indian. He started this movement because he started teaching as a professor in Kolkata University in 1826 to 1839. So when he started teaching people, those are the youngsters, they try to influence with Henry. And when they try to get more influence, he started giving up more knowledge and he started to capture what are the basic aspects of the social problems and he just tried to renovate them and just giving up more knowledge. In that type of period, he started giving those on knowledge in the Kolkata and the Bengal, some parts of the area. And, but this is a moment in the data when it is said it is like a 1820s to 1830s time. In the that time of period, that movement started. And for the, especially the Bengal, the youngsters. But after the 1830s, 30, in the age of 22 years, he was dying because of the cholera disease. Now, the next one is the Arya Samaj. Arya Samaj started by Dayanand Saraswati in 1875. His basically name is, the main name was the Mool Shankar, and he was a Gujarat. He was belong from the Kathiawad, Gujarat. And age of 21 years, he left the home. But when in his childhood, he don't like the English education. That's why he started to educate us a Sanskrit. So whatever education he got is all in a Sanskrit language, and according to all the Sanskrit language, he just start to reading his Vedas, Upanishads, all these things. When he left the home at the age of 21 years, after that, next 12 years, he start to encouraging, he start to taking the more interestful things. After that, he just established 1875 Arya Samaj, and in 1877 Arya Samaj branch in Lahore. He started one branch in Lahore also, and he gave some aims. What are the aims for the Brahma Samaj? That once some aims are that all Hindus should be follow the one formless God. It is the main aim of the Vedic literature also. Then the next one, that no one is a Shudra or Brahmin, because according to some literature, according to some social belief, it is a caste description is coming. So that's why he said there is a, no one is the Shudra or no one is a Brahmin. All are the equals. Then he said that encouragement of inter-caste marriage. It means if persons, they want to do the marriage with one caste or another caste, they can do it. It's called inter-caste marriage. And he, rejection of the polygamy and child marriage. He started to give knowledge that man and woman are the equals. And all the Vedas are the importance, and the ancient texts are preached. After he started the cow protection movement also, because according to Vedic literature, cow is also considered God for Hindus. And he started the Shuddhi movement also according to Vedic literature. The next one is the Prarthana Samaj. Prarthana Samaj is also influenced by the Brahma Samaj. And he was started by 1867 in Bombay by Dr. Atmaram. He was also the same kind of things he was provided, like the education for women. He opposed to sati system. He encouraged to widow remarriage. He started to give relief from the child marriage. All these things. And Britishers also support to all these ethics. So this all are the social reformer movements from 18th century, in the starting 18th century. So according to this, the main problems of the society, which is the discrimination, then the child marriage, then the widows, there is opposition of the widows remarriage, sati system, those kind of things stopped. So today I am going to bind my